Hello and I welcome you to my video classes on concrete technology. And in this video we are mainly discussing about special concretes. So in the special concrete, right, it is mainly about self-compacting concrete. So myself Vishwanath Avati, assistant professor in the department of civil engineering, Jain College of Engineering, Belagavi. So and in this video we are mainly discussing about concept of self-compacting concrete, materials, properties, and to check the properties, what are the different tests we are conducting. So now we'll understand, right, what do you mean by self-compacting concrete. Self-compacting concrete can be defined as a fresh concrete. So it is a fresh concrete that flows under its own weight. So concrete will flow under its own weight and does not require any external vibration to undergo compaction. See, now there is no requirement of any compaction. That's what it is called as self-compacting concrete, and it is flow its own weight, under its own weight. Now, it is used in the construction where it is very hard to use vibrators for the consolidation. So we have some concrete, right? So some places will be not same for all, placing of concrete will be not same for all the places. Some places there will be a complexity or very dense or very congested reinforcement will be there. So in that places it is very difficult to use the vibrator. So in those places we can use self-compacting concrete. So it will flow under its own weight and no need of any vibrators. Right. So how it is, why it is getting these kind of properties? Why? Because it has some abilities. Abilities means filling ability, passing ability, and segregation resistance. These are the three parameters or three properties which possess the self-compacting concrete, right? And mainly it is a flowing ability in a fresh state. Flowing ability in a fresh state, it was the main parameter, right? So it increases the self-compacting concrete parameters, right? So now we'll discuss mainly about what are the different materials we are using to prepare the self-compacting concrete. So here also it is what some change is there. It is not same as ordinary concrete. So and here some small changes of mineral admixtures and chemical admixtures and percentage of water. So we'll discuss one by one, right? First parameter we are discussing here, one is binding material. So every concrete required a binding material. So here binding material is cement and plus admixtures are there, but cement here they specifically they specified we have to use 42 or 53 grade of cement, right? Ordinary Portland cement of 43 to 53 grade. Next is aggregate. So aggregates are we have to take care about it. Why? Because it has some standards. So one is the size of aggregate used for self-compacting concrete design is limited to 20 mm. So here to prepare or to make the design, here is maximum size of the aggregate is what? 20 mm of aggregate, coarse aggregate. If the reinforcement employed for the structure is congested or complicated, the aggregate size used can be in the range of 10 to 12 mm. See, here it is, if a reinforcement in the structure is very congested or very dense reinforcement, then it is restricted to use of the range of 10 mm to 12 mm, right? So well grade aggregate either round or cubical shape are the best choice. So if you want to prepare a very good self-compacting concrete, then the best aggregate or coarse aggregates are cubical shape or round shape. You can see in the image here, these are the round shaped aggregate and here some cubical shapes are there, right? And it is what? Coarse aggregate. So best choice is round and cubical. Next is fine aggregate used in self-compacting concrete, either natural or manufactured aggregate. Fine aggregate. Fine aggregate means what? Sand, right? So it may be used as a natural aggregate or fine aggregate. It may be a river sand. River sand is the best example of fine aggregate. And it is in the natural form, right? We are getting in the natural form. But even nowadays we are using manufacturing fine aggregate. Manufacturing fine aggregate is what? M sand. So M sand is, M indicates manufacturing sand. It may be a natural sand or it may be a manufacturing sand. And the fine aggregate with the particle size less than 0.125 mm are generally employed. So here also some restriction is there. We have to use a fine aggregate of less than 0.125 mm. Next is water. So even water is very important, which makes the mixing and binding, even it has some role. But here some restriction is there. Restriction means what? We have to use a very less content. And what kind of characteristics are different, standards we are using for reinforced concrete and pre-stressed concrete? Same standard of conditions we are using for preparation of self-compacting concrete. Here it is, quality of water used is same that followed for reinforced concrete and pre-stressed concrete construction. So next is very important, right? Very important is mineral admixtures. So here we are using mineral admixtures, and use of mineral admixtures, it depends on the requirement of the property and design of the concrete mix. So here concrete mix, it mainly controls design of the concrete mix and as well as requirement of the concrete, right? So it all depends on the requirement of concrete. So some of the mineral admixtures and what are their properties we'll discuss. So one is ground granulated blast furnace slag, right? So here it is, what it is also one of the product, byproduct of iron production. So in the iron production, right, it will be melted, iron ores are melted in a blast furnace. So in that there will be a slag, that slag will be removed, and after removing with, and it is treated with the stream or water, we are getting some powder form of material. That powder form of material is called as ground granulated blast furnace slag, or in short form it is called as GGBS. We are using this for a self compacting concrete to increase the rheological property. So it is mean by, if you use this GGBS, the concrete will get a good viscosity and fluidity. Fluidity will be increased. When fluidity is good, then it is flowing capacity also increases. So next mineral admixture is fly ash. So fly ash is also one of the byproduct of a coal, but not byproduct, when we are using the coal to use as a fuel for some thermal power plant or in some industries, right, after burning the coal we are getting ash as a one of the product. So that is what called as a fly ash, and it has the same parameters or same characteristics of cement binding. It shows some binding characteristics, so that's what it is used. A fine fly ash particle helps to improve filling ability. So why you are using fly ash? It increases the filling ability of the internal concrete matrix with the fewer. Then it improves the quality and durability of the self-compacting concrete structures. So one fly ash, it increases the filling capacity in the four as well as durability and quality of the self-compacting concrete. So to improve durability and quality and filling ability, fly ash is used in a self-compacting concrete. Next is silica fume. Silica fume, the use of silica fume helps to increase the mechanical property of the self-compacting concrete structure. So if you want to increase the mechanical property of the self-compacting concrete structure, then it is you have to use silica fume. You can see in the image, it is what image of powder silica fume, and this image is powder of fly ash, fine fly ash. Next is stone powder. So stone powder, the use of stone powder in self compacting concrete used to improve the powder content of the mix. So here in mix design, so here some part of fineness will be there in the concrete. To increase the fineness content or fine content in the concrete, so here it is, they are using stone powder. So it is also very finer of stone powder, means what is the, even it will get in a stone quarry, but it is very finer, comparatively fine aggregate, lesser than size of fine aggregate. Next is chemical admixtures. So earlier it is mineral admixtures, and now we are using chemical admixtures. So in the chemical admixtures, mainly we are using super plasticizers. So why super plasticizers are used? Because we are reducing the water content. In an ordinary concrete, there is a plasticizer used. But in a self-compacting concrete, it is what we are using, one of the chemical admixture as super plasticizers to reduce the use of water. Right. So in order to improve freeze and throw resistance of concrete structure, we already studied what we mean by freezing and throwing effect on the concrete. So due to the less temperature, right, moisture in the concrete will be freezed and it created the ice. And when temperature increases, right, it is the frozen ice will melt or it makes soft. So due to the freezing and melting of water in the concrete, it makes the expansion and contraction of concrete. So due to that, maybe a cracks and structure will get fail. So to reduce that, we are using air entertaining agents as one of the chemical admixtures. Air entertaining agent, it is one of the agent, it is a chemical used to reduce the water as well as create the small bubbles inside the concrete. Next is to control setting time. Initial setting time, retarders are employed. Concrete retarders are employed, which enhances the or it increases the initial setting time. So now there is a comparison between ordinary concrete and self-compacting concrete. So here they are given different materials used, and here also they are given different materials used for self-compacting concrete. So we'll study one by one. One is aggregate. So here aggregate, gravel, coarse aggregate, and sand, fine aggregate. So comparatively, in ordinary concrete, coarse aggregate are used more, but here in self-compacting concrete, less comparatively. Next, sand. So sand, right, here also the sand quantity is same, almost same, but the total quantity of aggregate is less. Total quantity of aggregate is less. So next is cement. So cement, here it is very less, right, but here in binding material, in self-compacting concrete, is increases. Binding, yes, here it is, what, why increases? Because here is an increase in the cement as well as chemical admixtures. Then water plus plasticizers. So here it is more water and plasticizers, but here it is less water and some comparatively more use of super plasticizers. So next is properties of self-compacting concrete, right? The requirement of self-compacting concrete are achieved by properties. The requirement, so I told requirement means what is very good, right? So that goodness, it will come by its own property, that own property of fresh concrete. So it is what, here they are telling fresh concrete. The three main properties of self-compacting concrete are, one is filling ability. This property of the concrete is the ability to flow under its own weight. Filling ability means what? It is the filling capacity of the concrete by its own weight, right? So next is passing ability. This property is the ability of the concrete to maintain homogeneity. See here, it is what? A filling ability. Here it is what, due to this good condition, it fills the all the places. One is flowing. See here, is concrete is flowing from this place to here, right? But while flowing the concrete, it maintaining the homogeneity. How concrete is there in this place, similarly concrete will be there in other places. Next is segregation resistance. This is the resistance of concrete not undergo segregation when it flows during the self-compaction process. See here it is, you can see in the image, right? In this image, when it is placing, right, when the self-compaction is taking place, but here it is segregation is taking place. Segregation means what? Separation of fine aggregate, binding material, water and coarse aggregate. Right. So, but in a self-compacting concrete, it has a good resistance to segregation process. Next is test. Right. So, why tests are conducted? To check the whether it is giving a proper property or not. So, right, mainly we are checking filling ability by testing filling ability test. And to check the passing ability of the self-compacting concrete, then it is tested under passing ability of the test. So, next is segregation resistance property. To check the segregation resistance property, then test will be made. The test is segregation resistance test. So we have a table here, right? Different tests conducted on the self-compacting concrete to check the property. So first property to check is filling ability. To check the filling ability, some tests are there. One is, and here it is only naming are very important. And if you want more detailed study, then we have to refer some other videos. But here we have to remember only the namings. So one is to check the filling ability test, we are testing under slump flow test, T50 centimeter slump flow, Orient V funnel test, right? And to check the passing ability test, right? These are the some few test name of the few test. So one is L box test. So here box is created with a standard size, but it is in L shape. And they will pour the concrete on the top of the box and they will check how much passing ability of the concrete is there at the end, right? Similarly, J box is prepared, it is in the shape of J. So here also J check how passing ability is there in a curve shape, right? So then U box, so here also it is a U shape box, and under that they will check how passing ability is there in a U box, and some standards will be there, some with the compare with the standard values they will check. So next is fill box test, right? So these are the few tests to check passing ability. Similarly, some few tests are there to check the segregation resistance. One is V funnel test at T5 minutes. Next is GTM screen stability test, right? I think you understood what are the different name of the test to check the different properties, right? So now I'll end up with this video with one of the very beautiful and very motivative proverb. And the proverb says, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So very motivative, and it has a very good meaning, and it is a Chinese proverb, a journey of 1,000 miles, right? For example, if you want to travel from one place to another place, right, it may be a very 2,000 kilometer or 3,000 kilometer, but it will start with a single step, right? So that's what in our life also, we have very big dreams. But very big dreams also, it will start with a single works, right? So that's what we have to focus on, single small work. So definitely it will reach us up to big work. So thank you for watching this video.